Industries today are shifting towards predictive diagnostics to reduce downtime and improve operational efficiency. One major challenge is collecting important data like operational commands, diagnostic information, and self-test results without disrupting the system's normal operation. Traditional systems rely on microcontrollers to manage both control and data logging. But what if we could offload this data logging to a separate device? This is where a signal sniffer comes in. In this project, we demonstrate how a separate microcontroller unit can act as a signal sniffer, logging all the data exchanged between devices and sending it to the cloud for further analysis. We'll show you how to set up a CAN-based data monitoring system using Arduino Uno R4 boards. We'll capture operational data, send it to the cloud, and demonstrate how this data can be used for predictive diagnostics, all without disrupting normal system operations. We'll be using three Arduino Uno R4 devices in this setup, each with a specific role in the system. In our system, A1 acts as the power module, A2 is the control unit, and A3 is the signal sniffer. A1 has 5 internal registers for voltage and current settings, as well as status registers to monitor conditions like high or low voltage or current faults. A2 sends control commands to A1, and A1 responds with acknowledgement data. All of this communication happens via the CAN 2.0B protocol, which uses a 29-bit identifier and operates at a baud rate of 125 kbps. Meanwhile, A3 is our signal sniffer. It listens to all data being exchanged between A1 and A2 and sends this information to a connected PC. Let's start by wiring up the hardware. Connect the CNH and CNL lines between A1, A2, and A3 to form a common CAN bus. Make sure the connections are secure to avoid communication issues. Next, we'll program the Arduino boards. All the Arduino Uno R4 boards are connected to different COM ports. A1 stores data in registers for voltage and current and monitors fault conditions. It will send this data back to A2 after receiving commands. Now, we upload the code to A2. This code sends control commands to A1, such as setting the voltage and current. A2 also reads back the status from A1's registers to ensure everything is functioning properly. Finally, A3 is programmed as a signal sniffer. It listens to all CAN messages exchanged between A1 and A2, logging the data without interfering with the control flow. Now, we'll set up the Python script on the PC connected to A3. This script reads the CAN data via the serial port and logs it to a MySQL database and Google Sheets. First, we establish a serial connection to A3 and begin reading the incoming CAN data. Then, we format the data and send it to our MySQL database for long-term storage. We also use the Google Sheets API to display real-time data in a dynamic table, making it accessible from anywhere. The data we collect is displayed in real-time on Google Sheets, and we've integrated it into a WordPress blog for easy access. This allows operators to monitor the status of their systems remotely. Using this data, we can perform predictive diagnostics. By analyzing trends over time, we can predict potential issues before they cause downtime, ensuring smoother operations and minimizing disruptions. That's it. We've successfully set up a CAN-based data monitoring system with Arduino Uno R4 boards, sending data to the cloud for real-time monitoring and predictive diagnostics. If you found this tutorial helpful, be sure to like, share, and subscribe for more videos like this. For any questions, feel free to leave a comment below.